Once, dragons and men coexisted. They shared a peace forged in wisdom. A peace that lasted many generations. All that was lost when mankind disrupted this balance in a sudden onslaught. Man fought dragon in a savage war that shook the foundations of their world. This war was called the Scouring. Defeated and humbled, dragons vanished from the realm. In time, man rebuilt and spread his dominion across the land and on to the islands beyond. A millennium has passed since those dark days ended. What up, gamers? T.U.G here, and it's time to start a brand new Ultimate Let's Play. And I have chosen Fire Emblem from the Game Boy Advance. Now in Japan, this is known as Fire Emblem the Blazing Blade. This was the first Fire Emblem game to make it to North America, and aside from Smash Brothers, was my first real exposure to the franchise. If you played games like Advance Wars in the past, or have seen my past runs of Path of Radiance or Three Houses, this game plays similar to that. It's a combination strategy game slash RPG. Now, I'm playing the Nintendo Switch Online version, which came out not too long ago, and because this can be a rather difficult game, I will use save states as needed to both save time and headaches. I plan to get through this game without losing a single ally, because in this franchise, once a unit dies, they're gone for good. And this was before the days of Divine Pulse, the more current games, so I may need to use it time and time again in case I goof up, which honestly, it's probably going to happen at least a couple times. And right now we're getting a rough idea of the different classes in this game and what their strengths and weaknesses are. If I were to let this intro go on, well, it actually just ended there, so we're ready to get going here. So let's get started. Game on. New game. You are a tactician traveling across Elib. Set your name, birth month, and gender. Use the control pad and the A button to enter info. To start with the default settings, simply select No. Enter information? Yes, I will. I am going to use the default name of Mark. That is the default tactician's name, but I am going to put in my real birth month, which is July. I guess that makes me fire elemental in this realm. Alright, and I think that's going to be it. Are these things you want to use? Yes. I'm about to begin the prologue chapter. A Girl from the Plains. Are you awake? I found you unconscious on the plains. I am Lynn of the Lorca tribe. You're safe now. Who are you? Can you remember your name? Your name is Mark. What an odd sounding name. But pay me no mind. It is a good name. I see by your attire that you're a traveler. What brings you to the Sakai Plains? Would you share your story with me? What was that noise? I'll go see what's happening. Mark, wait here for me. Oh no, bandits! They must have come down from the Burned Mountains. They must be planning on raiding the local villages. I have to stop them. If that's all of them, I think I can handle them on my own. You'll be safe in here, Mark. What? You want to help? Well, can you use a weapon? I see, so you're a strategist by trade. And not a profession, but... Very well, we'll go together. Over here. If you want to help, Mark, I could use your advice. I'll protect you, so stay close to me. Okay, unit information. Lin is the blue unit. The enemy units are red. Mark, you are green. Essentially, battle consists of blue allied units and red enemy units taking turns moving onto the field. You're only a strategist. You're only here as a strategist, Mark. You only appear during special events. Your job as a strategist is to place a cursor on blue units to issue their orders. First, select a unit. Place the cursor on Lin, press the A button. So basically, this is a tutorial chapter. Let me toggle some options first here. If it'll let me. If I find the right button here. Here we go. Let me keep the animation on. Game speed, or text speed I want max. Everything else, yeah, we'll give all of that. We'll keep all that stuff here. We'll keep the default. I just wanted to speed up that text a bit because it was getting annoying just pressing the button there. Anyway, now the first couple of chapters in this game are going to be a lot of kind of forced action here. But these chapters are designed to give you an idea of what to expect and how to play the game. I need to be closer to the enemy. You selected Lin. When a unit is selected, the map changes color like so. Lin can move anywhere in the blue area. Move here to this place with the flashing cursor. Place your cursor there and press A button to finish. So we're going straight west here. This should be close enough, and now we'll just wait. Uh-oh, the bandit spotted me. He's coming this way. But he didn't reach us. Let's close in and attack. Okay, select Lin. Move to one of the areas adjacent to the bandit. I have to be right next to him to attack. So we'll put him right here. Now strike. Select attack. I have one iron sword. That number, I think we'll probably get a little less than that later on, is how many times you can use it before it breaks. Now looking at this, that's how much damage how much HP we have. The might indicates how much damage we're going to do in a single attack. If you're quick enough and have a good enough weapon, you can attack twice or even more. The hit is the percentage of the chances you're going to connect with your weapon. So I'm guaranteed to hit this guy twice. And then I also have a 3% critical ratio. If you are lucky enough to get a critical hit in battle, it will do triple the normal damage. Luckily, he swung and missed, and we got two good shots in, and we get experience. Now he's going to attack. He actually connected with 39% accuracy, but we got the kill. So you get experience if you fight, but you get more if you win. Victory! But I've been injured. I have need of a vulnerary. Select Lin. There's another bandit over by the Gur to the west. You don't know what a Gur is? It's a type of round hut. Many nomads live in huts like these. I would do well to use this time to administer a little first aid. Move to the space marked by the flashing cursor. We'll use an item. I'm carrying a couple of vulneraries in my satchel. They should heal me up. Would you get one for me? Open the item, select the vulnerary, and click use. The vulneraries will heal up 10 HP, which is just enough for Lin. And this guy's going to stay put at the Gur. Thank you, Mark. Now let's go get that brigand over by the Gur. Alright, we'll get right next to him and attack. Alright. Who you think you are? You think you can stand up to Bada the Beast? Ooh, that hurt. That means if he hits me again, I'm dead. Whew, he's tough. It all comes down to this next blow. Mark, if I fall, I want you to flee. You must escape. Also, the bosses can heal if they stand on a certain square. Luckily, he missed. And Lin gets the critical hit. What? How? How did you? A nice chunk of experience and a level up. Every 100 experience points, you get a level up. And it's really random on what stats get the boost, but we got quite a few stat boosts right there. Whew, that was close. I sorely underestimated him. Sorry if I worried you. I need to be stronger if I'm going to survive. Strong enough that no one can defeat me. Lin gains experience in each encounter. When she has enough experience, she'll level up. As she increases in level, her abilities improve. Over time, she'll grow much stronger. It's time to bring this chapter to a close. Select Lin and move her to the gate where Bada the Beast was standing. Select Seize to complete Lin's victory and your own. So basically, we're seizing the gate. And that's it. Good work, Mark. Let's go home. Good morning, Mark. Are you awake yet? That fight yesterday must have taken a lot out of you. Say, Mark, I want to talk to you about something. You have some experience in the ways of war, I can see. Would you allow me to travel with you? What, you want me to get permission from my parents? My mother and father died 6 months ago. My people, the Lorca, I'm the last of my tribe. Bandits attacked and they killed so many people. The tribe was scattered. My father was our chieftain, and I want to protect our people. But I'm so young and so old-fashioned, they wouldn't follow a woman. No one would follow me. I'm sorry, I've been alone for so long. No more. I will shed no more tears. Thank you, I'm better now. Mark, I must become stronger so that I may avenge my father's death. Yesterday's battle taught me something. I won't become stronger by sitting here alone. Mark, tell me you'll train me and that you'll let me travel with you. You will? That's wonderful. Thank you. Oh, thank you. We'd be better off working together, I know it. You'll be my master strategist and I'll be your peerless warrior. We can do it, right? Travel with Lin, Mark. Give her your aid and master the art of combat. Complete the tasks set out in each chapter and help Lin in her quest. Turn the instruction window on or off by pressing select. Alright, well that concludes the prologue chapter of Fire Emblem The Blazing Blade. I'm going to go ahead and call quits here. This is just a little warm-up for what's to come ahead. And we'll officially begin chapter 1 in the next episode. So until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.